When I steeped myself in prayer, I was transported in spirit to the chapel, where I saw the Lord Jesus exposed in the monstrance. I saw the glorious face of the Lord, and he said to me,
"What you see in reality, these souls see through faith. Oh, how pleasing to me is their great faith. You see, although there appears to be no trace of life in me, in reality, it is present in its fullness in each and every host. But for me to be able to act upon a soul, the soul must have faith. Oh, how pleasing to me is a living faith." Diary, 1420.
O blessed host, in golden chalice enclosed for me, that through the vast wilderness of exile I may pass, pure, immaculate, undefiled. O grant that through the power of your love this might come to be. O blessed host, take up your dwelling within my soul. O thou my heart's purest love, with your brilliance the darkness dispel. Refuse not your grace to a humble heart. O blessed host, enchantment of all heaven, though your beauty be veiled and captured in a crumb of bread, strong faith tears away that veil. Diary 159. When I was receiving Holy Communion today, I noticed in the cup a living host which the priest gave to me. When I returned to my place, I asked the Lord, "Why was one host alive, since you are equally alive under each of the species?" The Lord answered me,
"That is so. I am the same under each species, but not every soul receives me with the same living faith as you do, my daughter, and therefore I cannot act in their souls as I do in yours." Diary, 1407.
After communion today, Jesus told me how much he desires to come to human hearts.
"I desire to unite myself with human souls. My great delight is to unite myself with souls. Know, my daughter, that when I come to a human heart in Holy Communion, my hands are full of all kinds of graces which I want to give to the soul. But souls do not even pay attention to me. They leave me to myself and busy themselves with other things. Oh, how sad I am that souls do not recognize my love. They treat me as a dead object." Diary, 1385.
On leaving the earth, O Lord, you wanted to stay with us, and so you left us yourself in the sacrament of the altar, and you opened wide your mercy to us. There is no misery that could exhaust you. You have called us all to this fountain of love, to the spring of God's compassion. Here is the tabernacle of your mercy. Here is the remedy of all our ills. To you, O living spring of mercy, all souls are drawn. Some like deer, thirsting for your love. others to wash the wound of their sins. And still others, exhausted by life, to draw strength. At the moment of your death on the cross, you bestowed upon us eternal life, allowing your most holy side to be opened. You opened an inexhaustible spring of mercy for us, giving us your dearest possession, the blood and water from your heart. Such is the omnipotence of your mercy. From it all grace flows. Diary 1747. Merciful Lord, you told Saint Faustina in a revelation that we are to show mercy to our neighbors always and everywhere, and we must not shrink away from it or try to excuse or absolve ourselves from it. You gave us 3 degrees in order to exercise this mercy. The first by deed, the second by word, and the third by prayer. Most merciful Jesus, in the most blessed sacrament of the altar, we humbly come before the throne of mercy and bring before your merciful heart the souls of the sick and those that are dying in this hour. May they escape the fires of hell, for they are in most need of your mercy during this most crucial time. Eternal Father, we offer you the Divine Mercy Chaplet as an act of spiritual mercy for these souls and for the good intentions of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and for Father Murphy, whom you have chosen to lead our parish according to your divine purpose. Keep him holy and keep him safe for eternal life. Father God, we continue to pray for the conversion of Russia and for Ukraine and its people. And we ask for an end to the Russian aggression on that country and an end to war. We pray for those souls and those on our own border. We appeal to your merciful heart and ask that you bring peace to those poor countries and to the world. Peace that only you can bring. And we thank you, God of fathomless mercy, for allowing us to give relief and help to the sick and the dying by means of this chaplet. We bring Peter Oliveira, Katie Pitsley, and Tim Keating before your merciful heart, and the personal intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Saint Faustina, pray with us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Divine Mercy Chaplet. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Eternal Father, I offer you the body and the blood, soul and divinity of your dearly beloved Son.
Let's on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. For the sake of a sorrowful
for the sake
Have mercy on us.
mercy is endless and the treasury of compassion inexhaustible, look kindly upon us and increase your mercy in us, that in difficult moments we might not despair nor become despondent, but with great confidence submit ourselves to your holy will, which is love and mercy itself. Amen. the divine praises.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be a holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be a glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
May the heart of Jesus in the most blessed sacrament be praised, adored, and loved with grateful affection at every moment in all the tabernacles of the world, even to the end of time. Amen.